Hey everybody, it's Brian Lohnes with the NHRA on Fox, here today with a great announcement for our 2022 NHRA Camping World Drag Racing Series schedule. You know, we have a lot going on for the 2022 season, and one of the big questions that's been lingering since the end of 2021 are, where are my favorite classes going to race? That's what we're going to talk about today. We'll be telling you where six specific categories are going to race. I'm talking about Pro Stock, I'm talking about Pro Stock Motorcycle, the Constant Aviation Factory Stock Showdown, Top Fuel Harley, Pro Modified, and our Mountain Motor Pro Stockers. And before we get going with this, I'll let some audience kind of come into our live streaming discussion here. We will be available to take some questions, so if you want to fire any questions in the chat area, you can do that. You know, there are some major overriding stories for the 2022 season, the biggest one being us going back to three tracks that we haven't been to in a while. The NHRA Camping World Series will visit Phoenix again for the first time in a long time, Richmond, Virginia, and Seattle, Washington. Those three tracks we were not at during the 2020 go-around, and we were not at during the 2021 season either, so it'll be fantastic to get back and see our fans in those areas. So the Top Fuel and Nitro Funny Car categories, as you would expect, will be contested at each one of the 22 events on the 2022 NHRA Camping World Drag Racing Series Tour. It bears mentioning that that tour will start at the Winter Nationals in Pomona and is planned to end at the Auto Club Finals, also in Pomona, and it will be the first time in years that we have the, let's call it, proper beginning and end to a season at Pomona to start and at Pomona to close. The action that we saw at Pomona just a couple weekends ago last weekend, was astonishing. It was a great way to end the year, crowning our four Camping World Series champions, along with a few of our champions in the Lucas Oil Drag Racing Series as well. The action came down late in the rounds on Sunday in Pro Stock and Nitro Funny Car and in Pro Stock Bike. And Steve Torrance closed things up early on Sunday with his first round victory in the Top Fuel category, collecting his fourth straight championship. So now that we know a little bit of the overriding schedule in terms of 22 events, going back to places like Phoenix, Richmond, and Seattle, and the fact that our Funny Car and Top Fuel categories will be at all 22 of those events, let's talk a little bit about Pro Stock and where we're going to find them over the course of 2022. It will be an 18-race campaign for the Pro Stock Eliminator category, and it will begin at the Winter Nationals. In fact, Pro Stock will run the first five races of the season straight before taking a two-race hiatus in Charlotte for the four-wide Nationals in Richmond. They will then run the next seven races straight until we get to Brainerd, Minnesota, where they will take a one-race hiatus before running at the U.S. Nationals. After the U.S. Nationals, they'll take a hiatus for Reading, and they will run a five-race countdown to the championship beginning in St. Louis and running to the end of the year. The 18-race schedule is something that was brought into play several years ago when the Pro Stock category reconfigured itself, and it has led to increased car counts, increased interest, and certainly some of the best side-by-side competition we have seen in years. Now we go to the Pro Stock Motorcycle category. That will be a 15-race season for Pro Stock Motorcycle. It will begin, as Pro Stock Motorcycle traditionally does, in Gainesville, Florida. They'll run Gainesville, have a hiatus for the Las Vegas one race, then they'll run the next three races straight in Houston, Charlotte, and Richmond before taking a weekend off of Epping, New Hampshire. After that, it's another four-race pull, racing at Bristol, Norwalk, Denver, and Sonoma, and traditionally they take Seattle off, and they will take Seattle off this year as well. The Pro Stock Motorcycle program will pick back up at the U.S. Nationals. They'll run in Reading, take the weekend off in Charlotte, and then close the season with four straight races in St. Louis, Dallas, Las Vegas, and Pomona at the finals. That's a very traditional schedule for our Pro Stock Motorcycle category and kind of brings them back to where we expect them to be across the nation for that 15-race series. Now we're going to talk about the Constant Aviation Factory Stock Showdown. This is a category that Aaron Stanfield has won back-to-back world championships in. He's going to be shooting for a three-peat in 2022. They're going to start the season in Gainesville, Florida. Then they'll move to Charlotte, Richmond, Bristol, Norwalk, Indy, Reading, and Dallas. Those are the eight races they'll contest, and I'll run through them one more time. Factory Stock Showdown will be run at Gainesville, the four-wide Nationals in Charlotte, Richmond, Virginia, Bristol, Tennessee, Norwalk, Ohio, the U.S. Nationals in Indy, Reading, Pennsylvania, and they'll close their season in Dallas. The Constant Aviation Factory Stock Showdown has been electrifying to watch for the last couple of seasons and continues on a torrid pace in 2022. Let's talk about the E3 Sparkplugs Pro Modified season and what that's going to look like. It will be a 10-race pull for Pro Modified teams in 2022. It will start in Gainesville, Florida. It will continue at the four-wide Nationals. The Pro Modifieds will race in Richmond. They'll race in Norwalk, Topeka, Kansas, Brainerd, Minnesota, the U.S. Nationals, the Charlotte Fall Race, St. Louis, and this year they'll close their season in Dallas. Traditionally, the Pro Modified category has closed out in Las Vegas. But for 2022, Dallas will be the final stop, and I'll run through those 10 races one more time. Gainesville, Charlotte Four Wide Nationals, Richmond, Norwalk, Topeka, Kansas, Brainerd, Minnesota, the U.S. Nationals in Indy, the Charlotte Fall Race, St. Louis, and Dallas will be the 10 stops for the 2022 season of the E3 Spark Plugs NHRA Pro Modified category presented by J&A Service. Next up will be the Top Fuel Harley-Davidsons. A six-race program is set up for Top Fuel Harley in the 2022 calendar. It begins in Gainesville, Florida, continues with Charlotte, then it's Richmond, Virginia, Bristol, Tennessee, Indy, and the Top Fuel Harley season will close out in Dallas. One more time, that's Gainesville, Charlotte, Richmond, Bristol, Indy, and Dallas for our Top Fuel Harley category. And finally, the Mountain Motor Pro Stockers will be back for four appearances in 2022, starting in Richmond, then in Brainerd, Minnesota, at Indy for the U.S. Nationals, and at the Fall Charlotte race. Once again, that's Richmond, Brainerd, Indy, and Fall Charlotte, the four appearances the Mountain Motor Pro Stockers will be making. So that's the spread of those categories as we run through them. You're going to be able to check this out on NHRA.com as well, as the whole schedule will be posted. Now, for the Lucas Oil Drag Racing Series categories, I'm going to tell you to go to that NHRA.com website to get the detailed schedule there. If you want to learn about when Top Alcohol, Funny Car, and Dragster will be running, there are 15 national events that those will be contested at. Categories like Vortex Superchargers, Top Sportsman, and Top Dragster, Super Comp, Super Stock, Stock, Super Gas, Comp Eliminator, the entire run will be shown for your planning privileges, if you will, on NHRA.com. 2022 is going to be a great season, and it's always kind of fun to see where we spread these categories out at, giving the fans a variation of action across the course of the year. Certainly going to be watching the Pro Stock category as there are new faces coming in with Cameron Caruso and the folks at Titan Racing Engines joining the category full-time for 2022. There's going to be some shifting of teams, some shifting of wrenches, and certainly some shifting of talent, as there will be across the majority of NHRA Camping World Drag Racing Series categories over the course of this offseason. We're going to continue to have a bunch more news for you over the course of the offseason, but wanted to get this to you first. For you hardcore Pro Stock fans, if you're planning your race attendance schedule next year, you want to get to one with Pro Stock, or maybe you want to see the Pro Modifieds, the Mountain Motor Pro Stockers, or even the Constant Aviation Factory Stock Showdown category, now is your option to look across the schedule and see which races best fit your spectating needs. And if you're a racer, you can plan your racing schedule out starting officially right now. Now I'm going to see if we have any of our questions in here. Will Factory Stock Showdown run four wide? That question coming in from Joe Costello. Joe, I don't know. I'm going to guess maybe. How about that? That's a very non-committal answer. I'm going to guess maybe the Factory Stock Showdown cars will run four wide. The Pro Modifieds do it. We have run our Camping World categories four wide for several years now, and it would make sense and it would be very fun to see Factory Stock Showdown cars presented by Constant Aviation running four wide. Stan and Sheila Holt asking, what about the new Factory Experimental category? We'll have more information on Factory Experimental coming in a few weeks. That class is already set up in Competition Eliminator, so it will be available at Lucas Oil, Drag Racing Series events. It will also be available when Competition Eliminator is contested at national events. That said, there will be a handful of races where the brand new NHRA Factory Experimental category is showcased in its own standalone exhibition eliminator. So please stay tuned for more information on specifically where those events will be. If I had to guess, one of them will probably be the U.S. Nationals. That might be a safe bet. Outside of that, we'll be back with more information on Factory Experimental and those exhibition races. But again, if you want to run the category, if you're building a car to fit the category, Competition Eliminator will be contested at the majority of national events, and your Factory Experimental car has a class in comp ready, willing, and able to contain it. Another question coming in here as I'm using my phone to communicate with our social media expert, Nikki Shealy. As you wait for that question to come in, it's really fun to look at this schedule and kind of consider the fact that pretty much everybody's running these great kind of clumps of back-to-back-to-back races. Pro Stock Motorcycle kind of starts and takes a bit of a layoff, and then they run for a stretch. The Pro Stockers starting with five straight events, taking a short break, and then running seven straight, really going to set up some great storylines. Roger Rigsby asks, back to four qualifying sessions. Roger, I can't answer that question. I think we may have some races with four qualifying sessions. I think we may have some races with three qualifying sessions. I do not believe, at least I have not been told or heard directly, that four qualifying sessions will go back to being the standard of the series. That information will be forthcoming as well. I can tell you this, though. One of the things that we continue to talk about, need to continue to talk about, is our All-Star Shootout races coming for the Nitro Funny Car and Top Fuel categories. Remember, the Top Fuel event will take place in Gainesville. The Nitro Funny Car event will take place at the U.S. Nationals. And these eight qualifying positions will be garnered by points in qualifying. So you will earn points in qualifying in Top Fuel over the first two events, and then we'll run a shootout with a payout of $80,000 to win, and it works back down for an overall purse of over $130,000. Then when we go to the U.S. Nationals, our eight best qualifying funny cars will have their own standalone shootout race for the same amount of money. Those events are going to be awesome. So if you're planning on trying to see a shootout race this year, you have two options. You can go to Gainesville to the Gator Nationals to watch the Top Fuel shootout, or you can go to the U.S. Nationals to watch the Nitro Funny Car shootout, which promises to be a whole lot of fun for those eight cars that earn the spots to run for the money. So, I think we have run through the information. I want you to check back right here for the direct link to NHRA.com, or you can just keep checking on NHRA.com over the course of this day. The schedule will be posted plain as day, so you can print it off and make your marks on it and plan your own personal schedule out for 2022. And again, stay tuned to NHRA social media and across all channels for more off-season content. There is going to be a ton, and I'm talking a ton of breaking news coming from virtually every single category in the sport, both from the sanctioning body and certainly from the racers, the crew chiefs, and the crew people who continue to work their way around this wild world of drag racing. We can't wait to announce some cars that are coming back, some big names re-entering competition. It is all going to be fantastic this winter. Just make sure you follow us to stay on top of all of it. I'm Brian Lohnes. Thanks for watching our schedule announcement today. We'll be back with more content soon right here on NHRA.com and across our social media platforms.